passing up my grades to all the grades. To start my narrative on a lighter note, the topic today calls out the well-meaning politics is dead and the current situation demands a postmortem to pronounce its time of death and its reason. The emergence of right-wing politics is not just a universal phenomenon of this decade, but the most controversial and conclusive death knell of Puritan democracy in world politics. As you all are already aware of, right-wing populism, which is also known as a national populism, is a political ideology which combines right-wing politics and populist rhetorics which doesn't favor allies. Elites are not just incompetent and ineffective, but rather dishonest, self-serving, and profit-seeking. Now, let us just take the example of our own country, India. In India, right-wing populism came into the picture by the late 1980s by the current ruling party, BJP. The right-wing populism has been promoted by the RSS and has always stood against the persecution of Hindus over the centuries and has been attributed to the concept of Hindutva. A simple trend of the same example is that the BJP has become a significant force in the state legislative assemblies and in parliament by raising the issue of Ram Mandir temple by demolishing the existing Babri Masjid, which was believed to be constructed by demolishing a Hindu temple in Ayodhya. These are not isolated cases, as we see a rise in the strength of politics across the world. Now, a similar case when we take a look at the politics in Europe, the right-wing populism in Europe is described to political parties that are generally known for their opposition to immigration, especially for the Islamic world and for Euroscepticism. Euroscepticism means it's a criticism to the European Union and European integration. Right-wing populism in the Western world is generally dealing with ideologies such as anti-environmentalism, anti-globalization, neo-nationalism, and so on. The 2016 referendum decision by the United Kingdom to leave the European Union, which is now known as Brexit, is one of the most visible examples of the right-wing populism. Now, this revolutionary move has caused various disadvantages such as loss of freedom of movement, less opportunity for young people, social damage, economic cost, etc. Now, similarly, when we look into the politics in United States, we can see that paleoconservatism is mostly linked with right-wing populism. Paleoconservatism is a form of conservatism in the United States that stresses American nationalism, restricts immigration, decentralization, trade tariffs, and so on. We all know that Donald Trump is clearly a pro-white and a native American whose ideological vision is deeply paleoconservative, leads into racism and isolated foreign policy, and it causes against or it works against economic globalization. So to summarize, all the examples shown above shows that right-wing ideologies cause negative effects in one or the other way. A common trend is a fear or hatred towards outsiders, and the problem with its success is that it is contagious. As one party finds victory in this, other parties will have to follow the suit, or else they will have to attract anger, scream anger from other majority communities. So I would like to conclude to say that, but let me show you all how dangerous this is for a secular fabric of a country and how pluralism will be destroyed. So with this, I would like to conclude my speech with the hope to bring a better change in the coming ages. With this, I conclude my speech. Thanks to all, and we will be in our